Okay children, now we will discuss about cuboid. How to form a cuboid? Here we are using the two rectangles. Two rectangles form a one cuboid. Children, do you know where we are using this cuboid? Yes, cotton boxes, which is in the shape of a cuboid. Boxes. Yes. And the next one is cube. In this cube, how to frame the cube? Here we are using the two squares. Two squares form a one cube. Okay. Can you say the examples of cube? Where we are observing cube? For example, ice cube, Rubik cube, dice, which is in the shape of cube. Okay. And the next one is cone. Where we are using this type of, where we are observing this type of shape? Yes, cone ice cream. Do you like it? Yes. And the next one, birthday cap. These are examples of cone. Okay. And the next one is a cylinder. Cylinder. Which shape it is? It is a cylinder shape. Do you know where we are using? Yes, a glass, a chalk piece, which is in the shape of a cylinder. And the last one is spear. Last one is spear. Where we are using spear? Where we are observing in daily life? Do you like cricket? So how to play cricket? By using a ball. The ball is the shape of a spear. Or using the shape of a spear. Okay? These are the examples of 3D shapes. Children, what you do? First you will understand these 2D shapes and 3D shapes. After that, you will observe in your surroundings where which shape it is. You have to write that items. Okay. Now we discuss some more topic. Have you understood? So shapes may be divided into two types. That is 2D shapes and 3D shapes. 2D shapes having the two measurements and 3D shapes having the three measurements. Okay. And the next one is we will discuss about views of an object. Views of an object. Views of an object. What is the meaning of views of an object? That means a 3D object can look different in different directions. Okay, the 3D object having the different type of views in different directions. So we will observe with the examples. Okay, children, do you observe what it is? As it is a hut. What we have to observe when we see from the front side. This is the front side of the hut. When we see the front side, what you are observing is door, windows and the outline part of the roof. Okay, but here I am changing this direction. This object, I am changing this shape direction. Okay, now what you are to observing? Yes, you can't observe the windows, doors. That is front side different, side. When we change the direction, the side part is different. That means only we are observing half part of our roof. Okay. For example, if somebody is there in the terrace, if they observe or they will observe this hut, what can they will observe? Yes, they will observe only roof part. They will observe in the this object. Okay. So what you understood? Here the object is said, when we change the direction, the views are different. Okay, children. So here, where, how many types we are using? How many views here we are seeing here? Three views. What are they? What are they? The first one is front view. First one is front view. And the second one is we change the direction to the side. That is side view. Side view. And the last one is if someone is seeing on the terrace, only roof part. That is, we have to call a top view. So one object is same, but way of views are different. Okay. Let us see one more example. Children, what do you think? What is this? This is a car. Do you like it? Yes. Children, what we have to observe? If we this object, if we see them from front side, what we have to observe? Yes, lights, mirror, like that we have to observe it. When we change the direction, when we change the direction, what we have to observe? That is car door, tires, like that we are observing. Object is same. When we see the from top side, what you observe? The top part of the car, we will observing the object. Here the object is same, but the way of that, if we change the directions, the view is different. Okay, so every 3D object having the different views. Okay, and understood, in our daily life also we are seeing the different views of object. How many views are there? Yes, front view, side view and top view. Front view, side view and top view. And the next we will discuss about one more topic, that is net shapes. That is net shapes. What is the meaning of net shapes? What is the meaning of net shapes? A net shape, it is a 2D representation of 3D object. What is that? A 2D representation. 2D representation of 3D object. Representation of 3D object. For example, in the simple way, what we learn about net, it is the outline part of the 3D object. Outline part of the 3D object. For example, we will see some nets. Children, once observe this box, which shape it is? It is a cuboid shape. For example, if we open this box, what we have to observe? Let us see. So here I am opening this shape, this object. What you are observing? This is a outline part of the this box. Okay, outline part of the 3D object. Once we have to observe in 3D objects, once we have to observe these shapes, which shape it is? Yes, it is a 2D shape. That means it is a rectangle. That means a 3D object, outline of the 3D object depends upon a 2D shapes. Depends upon 2D shape. To make a 3D object, first we will make for using the 2D object. So this is a net shape of a cuboid. This is the outline part of the cuboid. For example, if we fold again, we will get the same box. We will get the same box. See, by using this net, we will make a cuboid by using the 2D shapes. Let us take one more example. Children, once we have to observe which shape it is? It is a cube. It is a cube. Again, if I open this box, what you have to observe? Which 2D figure you have to observe? Can you say? Can you observe which shape it is? It is a square. In the same way, this is the outline part of the given object. If you make the 3D object, we will depend upon 2D objects. This is the unfolded object of the 3D object. Okay, this type of outlines are called as net shapes. Outlines called as